Okay, David, I think Gabrielle might have heard me because one of my caster picks this weekend was Umbreon VMAX. I said that card was going to do well, and I think I can admit that in Masters, I was wrong. We haven't seen Umbreon all weekend. We're seeing it now.
Yeah, but seeing how many Mew we had in Masters Division, maybe the Masters also have something to learn from the Junior Division.
Maybe.
Who knows? We have in Masters, we have two Pokemon with Darkness Weakness in the finals, right?
We do. I mean, yeah, so it seems like, we've got Mew against Gardevoir. It seems like it'd be a good idea to have some Umbreon running around. I mean, we saw Aggron on stream,
yes.
And we didn't see Umbreon. That
should
was,
have put that on your list, right?
I should have put Aggron on my list. That would have been completely out of left field and would have gone well. So, we can say now, so Gabrielle is going to be playing an Arceus Duraludon Umbreon deck, the kind we saw do pretty well at North American Internationals. That deck was all over the upper reaches of the Top Cup. And Xiao Tong is going to be playing a Lost Zone deck, the kind of one we've seen before, going for Kyogre, obviously for that big game-ending attack at the end. And then we've got things like Dragonite V and Raikou V are in there as well. So it's the kind of one we've seen before. Some of the counts are a little bit different. We do have an Echoing Horn in there, which obviously these Lost Box decks like to play nowadays. So two decks we're familiar with and we've seen before.
Yeah, in the Masters Division, the Kyogre version is not the most popular.
No.
I think the one without the Kyogre is the most popular. Then the Kyogre, and then you have people like Pedro Torres who play Charizard in their deck. Very interesting to see the junior players also playing these, like, actually kind of complicated decks. I personally don't like the Kyogre deck because it's complicated and I don't have the nerves to be so
yes.
careful with my energy cards. Xiao Tong might have the upper hand compared to me, definitely, as he has shown already in the finals of the World Championships in the junior division, now trying to go for the victory here.
Yeah, this Lost Zone deck with Kyogre is complicated. You basically have to engineer a late game state where your deck is entirely energy. So when you're discarding cards on the top of your deck to do big damage with Kyogre, you are guaranteed to hit energy because that's all that's in your deck. So what you tend to see these players do is run through their deck entirely, then use Energy Recycler to put energy back into their deck. So their deck is literally just energy. And then, you know, after several turns of setup, you get this big smash with Kyogre at the end. It's not the only way the deck plays. Sometimes you'll be able to go through the whole game just using Sableye and Cramorant and cards like Dragonite and Raikou and never even need the Kyogre. But Kyogre is there for the big fancy ending. And when it works, it is a spectacular way to end the game. Arceus Duraludon, little more straightforward. You get your Arceus, you evolve up. Oh, but we can talk about that in a minute, David. We've got some accomplishments here.
Yeah, Xiao Tong had a very amazing season, was top 8 at the Taiwan Championships, also top 16 at the Regional League in Kaohsiung. This is basically like the old state championships we had in the USA, for example. Also top 4 at the Regional League in Tainan and top 8 in Taipei. And like I mentioned already, all with this same deck. Sableye, Comfey, Lost Vacuum, you have the whole crew together trying to get as many cards into the Lost Zone, and then use Sableye, Cramorant to use that to your advantage. Facing against Gabrielle, who of course plays in the same part of the world that all the Europeans, the Americas and Australia plays, so these names should be familiar to you. Regional champion, Sao Paulo. Everyone knows how difficult it is to win a regional championship.
Oh, yes.
This is the same for Masters, this is the same for Juniors. Also top 4 at the Chile Regional Championship, both of these tournaments with Lugia Single Strike. So Gabriel changed his deck for World Championship, trying to make a great meta call, which he definitely did, as we see the Lugia here on the table, which was the Pokemon that got him the invitation.
I mean, it's still represented pretty well on the table. When I went to introduce myself to the junior players, Gabrielle was holding a Mew plush, and then I went to speak to Xiao Tong, who told me that his favorite Pokemon was Mew.
Oh.
And yet neither player is playing Mew in the final, which is obviously one of the top decks at the moment.
Yeah, there seems to be a pattern there that people that love Mew end up actually not playing it at day 2 at the World Championship, as we see the prize cuts coming down. Gabriel.
Two Arceus V-Star and an Arceus V. There's only three Arceus V-Star in the deck. That is actually extremely relevant. The only Radiant Greninja being prior to Chao Tong is also a very big deal. And the only Kyogre. But do bear in mind, that is a late game play, and that will be one of the first prizes taken. But then there's also two Mirage Gate prize, and sure, you're going to play four Mirage Gate. I don't even need to look at the list. Of course you're playing four Mirage Gate. But yeah, these prizes are not great for either player. Two out of three Arceus V-Star on one side, and two Mirage Gate, and your only Radiant Greninja on the other. If either player knew what their prizes were, they would not be terribly happy about it. So there's going to be some challenges to navigate for both of these junior division players as they go through this matchup. But it does look like we're ready to start. There is a fist bump. We got Xiao Tongyan against Gabriel Torres, and we are off in the Juniors Division World Championship Final.
Yeah, the crowd is going wild, you see here.
That is not what you want to see. And there was a big ooh from the crowd. Now, I don't think there's really a turn one option for Gabriel to get the KO here, but this is still not good. Attaching the wrong energy to Sableye in passing, that's a bad turn one.
Yeah, Xiao Tong at the beginning when we were asking what is the coolest thing your deck can do, he said, yeah, a lot of damage very early on. Yeah, this is not a lot of damage very early on. This is like more of a desperation play. Let's hope that maybe there is a supporter card in Xiao Tong's hand that he just wasn't able to play, as we see Gabriel's turn here. The great thing about the Arceus deck is that the one thing that you basically need is just Arceus V energy, and this is basically the best turn one you can have. Yeah, like I said earlier, the Masters player, they always like to compare the decks to older decks. This is something reminding me a little bit of the version Genesect deck that we had almost 10 years ago now, as Gabriel just opens this game with a Trinity Charge attaching energies, and if Xiao Tong doesn't find anything useful here, this might be game over, but yeah, like we were hoping for, there was a Choruses experiment in Xiao Tong's hand, and because there is an energy attached to the active Pokemon, if we see a Comfey now, we will have a retreat and a proper game.
Yeah, I did spy that in his hand a second ago. Now, he has actually got Pokestop off of the Choruses experiment. This is a little bit risky, but it might be able to, you know, get him where he needs to go. So this is quite nice. We've got two cards on the Lost Zone. That turn one was terrible, no way around that. But now we've got Pokestop. You discard the top three cards of your deck. You get any item cards. Losing an energy, not ideal, but getting two item cards is not too bad. Now, we do see the Manaphy hitting the bench, not hugely important in this matchup. And that's a bad thing because you don't want Manaphy down, and we just retreat into the Manaphy. Xiao Tong's turn two was not that much better than his turn one, David.
Oh, yeah, this is looking, this is a very dire situation here, especially if Gabriel is able to find a Arceus V Star, which would then allow him to,
lost his orders onto the Sableye. But yeah, we just see the KO. There's no Arceus V Star, but you can do enough to get the KO there. We've got energy on the Umbreon. Now we do see another Pokestop coming down. So we got an Echoing Horn. We lose a Comfey. We get a Battle VIP pass, but that's no good because unfortunately it's not turn one anymore. So there's a lot of cards in Xiao Tong's hand, but there really isn't much
Clara
to go with. It's going to be Clara for a Comfey and an energy, but you're going to have to attach to Manaphy and retreat, and then you've got one flower selecting. That's pretty much the entire play here.
Yeah, this is not the best way to use Clara, but at least you're able to keep the game going. Even if this is not turning out to be a win for Xiao Tong, he can still just look at some cards, get a better feeling of what the opponent is doing, and you have enough time. We already mentioned this yesterday at the top eight matches that 75 minutes is enough. We see an escape rope.
It was Super Rod and Energy Recycler. They are both recovery cards. Xiao Tong's hand is full of cards he can't play right now. Recovery cards and Battle VIP Pass and Echoing Horn. These are great cards in the mid to late game or on turn one in the case of Battle VIP Pass. None of these cards are good right now. Xiao Tong needs Pokemon Search. He needs a way to get rolling, and he's not getting anything. So Gabriel is going two prizes up here.
Yeah, the only thing keeping a Xiao Tong here in this game is the fact that Gabriel's only supporter card is a Judge, which you definitely do not want to play in a situation like this, as Xiao Tong finds himself the second Choruses experiment now, hopefully for some better cards, as we see, yeah, Comfey, Battle VIP Pass, very easy choices. There was another Comfey there. So, yeah, the Lost Zone, there was a Lost City play to put the Sableye into the Lost Zone. Very good play, because Sableye is a very difficult Pokemon to deal with for every deck. And yeah, removing one completely from the game is a very strong play. Unfortunately, it does put your opponent one extra card into the loss zone, making Mirage Gate a little bit faster, giving your opponent the option to attack with Sableye faster, as this is definitely not decided yet, but a very difficult situation.
Oh, we see Ryko V coming down with a Forest Seal Stone. May well actually go for that Mirage Gate you just mentioned here, David. There are two prized. Now, it looks like we're going Dragonite instead. There are two Mirage Gate prized, but they are now on, they're online, so to speak. There are seven cards in the Lost Zone. I don't know if he's got one in his hand right now, but that's what I'd be looking for. We see the attachment. Do we? Yes, there is one in hand. There had to be, otherwise he would have grabbed it from the Forest Seal Stone. And he is actually going to be able to use Dragonite to get a KO onto the Umbreon and even up the prizes here, as long as we've got a pivoting option. Actually, has he got an escape rope in hand?
There was an escape rope. I think it was played last turn. There should still be one left. So in theory, that is on the table, and escape rope would be completely devastating in this situation here.
Yes, he's got one in hand. He can take out the Arceus here.
If you take out the Arceus here, then the whole game basically completely turns around. Like for Gabriel's situation, he knew, well, I have a supporter card. In theory, I could start drawing cards. But if I do that, then I give my opponent just a chance to completely get back to this game. As we saw, a very important draw from Shao Tonghun is now at 9 cards in the Lost Zone, I think.
Yes.
With the Lost Vacuum, as we see the Escape Rope, an amazing play.
This is huge.
Here.
I love this. Dragonite can use Dragon Gale for 250. And it does 20 to each of your bench Pokemon. You really don't care about that right now. Now we see the KO on Umbreon. And not only has Shao Tong gone and evened up the prizes, but he's taken out Gabriel's biggest attacking threat. And now, actually, the best attacker on the board is that Dragonite. And Gabriel, oh, he's got the Arceus V-Star in hand, but it's too late now.
Yeah, he got it from the prize cards after taking that last knockout last turn. Just one turn too late. Last turn with the Arceus V-Star, could have used V-Star power, get Professor's Research, attack, get more energy cards going. But because he wanted to apply pressure, just try to attack, didn't want to play the judge, had no way to attach more energy cards in play. So now it is very, very crucial for Gabriel to get another Arceus V, another energy card in play. You can get some damage with Moonlight Blade. Gabriel opting to go for the Radiant Alakazam, which here can kind of like outplay, make some use of the damage that you put on yourself when you attack with Dragonite V.
Yeah, and that judge is being played, and it's such an awkward situation. I've been on both sides of this. Sometimes you've got something like a judge, you don't play it, your opponent continues to draw nothing, and you win the game, and it's brilliant. But sometimes, like we saw in this game, you don't play the judge because you don't want to give your opponent a new hand because you know they've got nothing, but then all of a sudden they draw one card, which makes such a difference, and now they're in the lead, and you're sitting there thinking, I could have played judge a couple of turns ago, and I would be in a much better position right now. It's very hard to know without the benefit of hindsight,
oh,
what the decision is. You're owing David, you're not loving the hand.
No, there is no basic Pokemon, just a double turbo energy, which you can't really use. We see a Boss's Order energy card, Arceus V. None of these cards bring you closer to victory. Now you're just kind of stuck a little bit with your Umbreon active here. All you can do is just get a little bit of damage there. Not really too helpful. Moonlight Blade in theory can deal more damage if you have damage yourself, which is not the case right here. So we just see 80 damage, passing the turn to Shao Tong, who now can just attack with Dragonite, take out everything on Gabriel's board, and maybe even seal up the game in this turn.
And whiffing the Umbreon VMAX is pretty big there. Umbreon VMAX can tank a hit from Dragon Gale. Dragon Gale would not KO the VMAX, but it does KO the V right here. Shao Tong wasting no time, going up by 4 prizes to 2 taken, and actually gets 2 Mirage Gate, which are going to be great to see. Power up any Pokemon he wants at this stage, and Gabriel has very little on the board.
Yeah, even if Gabriel would have gotten the Umbreon VMAX, could have even taken a knockout here, together with the ability from Alakazam. You could have just taken the the Raikou on the bench. But now this is not an option anymore. There is no real Pokemon to use in play. Now all Shao Tong here needs is even just a boss's order to take out any Pokemon that Gabriel puts on his bench. If he doesn't put anything down, the game is over already. As we see Gabriel realizing this as well, and just packing up the game.
And Shao Tong goes one game up in a Juniors Division final. Sorry to cut you off there, David. And it's Dragonite. Turns out Dragon IV is good. At Oceania International Championships, I kept seeing this deck being called Dragonite Lost Box, and I casted like 3 games of it, and no one ever used Dragonite, and it made me sad. So being here at the World Championships watching the Juniors final and seeing Dragonite take every single prize all by itself, I feel like it's come full circle.
Yeah, Dragonite is an amazing card in this deck. Like the core strategy of the deck, you have your Radiant Greninja to get more cards, and then you use your Comfy to get cards in the Lost Zone, and you try to use Sableye's Lost Mine attack to outplay your opponent, and you have option with the Cramorant. And then you have a lot of energies that you can theoretically attach with Mirage Gate, so you're looking for like some Pokemon to abuse this. Dragonite V is the one single, easy-to-use basic Pokemon that deals the most damage, which also needs Water Energy cards, which is a great synergy together with Radiant Greninja. It also needs Lightning Energy, which is a great synergy with Raikou V, the other very easy-to-use, easy-to-put-down, easy-to-charge-up Pokemon V that can deal a lot of damage. And if you play some Pokemon V, it allows you to use the Forest Seal Stone, an easy way to get even more cards in the Lost Zone together with Lost Vacuum. All cards in Shaotong's deck are just working together perfectly.
Yeah, great explanation there, David, of the deck and how it works, and you're absolutely right. It's a deck that lost favor a little bit with some of the Masters. They've moved on to kind of other things. We did see some Lost Zone, generally not this kind of build with Kyogre, although it was out there in the field this weekend. We did see it around. But we saw an awful lot of Giratina. That seemed to be, well, especially in day one, and then day two, the traditional Lost Box was a little more popular. But this is one of those decks that's got a lot of tricks and a lot of things that you can pull off. And we saw there the first 2 turns for Shaotong were so bad, and yet being able to come through and win, only giving up 2 prizes, that is a remarkable recovery. So we're into game 2 here, and Gabrielle starts off with that perfect turn 1, Arceus double turbo.
And also this game is already looking completely different. Last game, Gabrielle's only supporter option was the Judge, which I think actually agree that you should not play it in a situation like this. It's obvious your opponent is not drawing well. Why take the big risk, give your opponent 4 random cards when you know just the 1 random card on top of the deck, as long as that is not a good one, I can win. Unfortunately, it didn't work out in this situation, but here we have Gabrielle going strong, Arceus, Energy. There are 2 great supporter options to draw more cards in the hand. I'm looking forward to a long and interesting game.
Yeah, it would be nice. Unfortunately, last game was a little bit weird. Shaotong didn't really do anything for the first couple of turns, but then he got rolling, and Gabrielle basically just sat there while all his Pokemon were KO'd. But here, we got a Comfey in the active for Shaotong. That is your preferred starting Pokemon in this game. You've got a turn 1 Corvus's Experiment. Looks like, I think, yeah, we're just making sure the correct number of cards are being put out there. And this is what players tend to do. Rather than actually drawing 5 cards, you put 5 cards down, you make sure you've got the right number, and then you can make that decision. Which 3 are going to go into your hand, which 2 are going to go into the Lost Zone.
Yeah, a very simple mistake there can always like cost you the whole tournament. We saw even this situation come up in the Master Division yesterday. If you're especially at the World stage, you got your time. Don't take any risks, just count your cards out perfectly. As we see, very, very different turn 1 from Shaotong, just going Chorus Experiment first. There is a Battle VIP pass that is already, in the optional cards that he is trying to put into his hand. Comfey active, Battle VIP pass for another Comfey, another card, probably a Radiant Greninja, which was, yeah, unfortunately priced last game, but did we see the prize cards yet?
I don't know if we've seen the prize cards yet. Maybe we can have a little bit of a reminder in a moment. But yeah, that Radiant Greninja has been eyed up straight away here. No surprises here. It's coming out, and that is absolutely what we want to be looking. There we see the prizes. Thank you very much. Ooh, 2 Arceus V prizes, not ideal, but we do know that the Arceus V is on the board. Now I'm looking to see there are 2 Forest Seal Stone in Shaotong's deck. Once again, that 1 of Kyogre is prized, but once again, it's at the bottom and it should be coming out pretty quickly. So not ideal that Gabrielle's got 2 Arceus prized, and not ideal that Shaotong's got a Forest Seal Stone prize, but this is not like it was in game 1. It looks like the prizes are going to be okay this game.
Yeah, it looks like a completely like fine distribution, also especially considering the matchup. You don't really want to use more than 2 Arceus V in this game, because the V-Star is a strong Pokemon, you can deal a lot of damage, but you really want to have a lot of HP, and this is where the VMAX Pokemon come into play. So yeah, putting down a third Arceus V is not necessarily necessary at all, as we see Shortong going for not a Comfey, because there was already Comfey in hand. As we see the concealed cards, draw two cards. Using Greninja first is a good play because you really need your information first. You know you will use Greninja anyways, you know you will use Flower Selecting anyways, but if you use Flower Selecting, you have to get rid of one of those two cards, and you want to make the best choice, and because of that, you want to know which cards you draw with Greninja first. So then you have more information to deal with, and you can make the better choice on your Flower Selecting. As you see, even the junior players are completely aware of these very, very small like sequencing rules. Shortong is really showing his experience with this deck.
Yeah, he's playing this deck absolutely beautifully. He does have a switch card here and an escape rope. Choosing to put the Cramorant active. Now, you've got the attack with Cramorant. I would have been tempted here to use escape rope and try and get a hit on one of the Pokemon V. But then again, we did see in the previous game that Dragonite was so good at knocking out those Pokemon V. And you can always, you know, that Radiant Alakazam, the first time Shaotong uses a Lost Mine on Sableye, that Radiant Alakazam is definitely going down. So it's not KO'd yet, but Sableye is going to finish it.
Yeah, also, having the Radiant Alakazam stay active creates like a extra annoyance for Gabriel, because usually you don't have so many switching options in the Arceus deck. So there is a small chance that maybe Shortong doesn't get it. On the other hand, as long as you get your Arceus V, V-Star, you can use Starbirth to just search for the one switching option. As we see, no Arceus V-Star in Gabriel's hand. This is, again, looking very problematic here.
I mean, he's got Luminion, so he can use Luminion to go and get a supporter card.
And there was already the research plate.
Ah, yes. But I mean, for next turn, yes, to kind of bail him out. But you're right, he needs the Arceus now. But Luminion is very, very fragile when you're facing down a Raikou V. So it's not a card you really want to put down for such an easy two prizes. So whiffing that Arceus V-Star is not a good idea. We're set up for next turn. But yeah, not getting Arceus V-Star turn two, when you're one game down and you're facing down this kind of setup, Shaotong managed to pull it back in game one with a very subpar setup in the first couple of turns. And that's putting it lightly. That is not the case here in game two. Shaotong is setting up absolutely beautifully. We had the turn one Cramorant. We've now got six cards in the Lost Zone. A single Flower Selecting is going to turn Mirage Gate on. And, oh, could we even... I'm trying to think whether Sableye could work this turn. I think that might be a bit too much of an extension. But Sableye this turn would be absolutely phenomenal.
Yeah, it is not completely impossible, especially because there is a Lost box decks compared to the Giratina have the option to use the Forest Seal Stone to search for Lost Vacuum, which is then able to just get rid of that one Forest Seal Stone that you used to look for the Vacuum, and then you can use those cards to put two extra cards into your Lost Zone. So in theory, if Shortong really wants to go for it, this is an option that is on the table. But we see here, Pocket Stop, discarding a Comfey and the Dragonite V that put in so much work last game.
And there's only one Dragonite V in the deck here, David. You do not want to see Dragonite V hitting the discard pile. I mean, yeah, there's going to be a way to get it back. There's two Super Rod in the deck. But you don't want to have to Super Rod it back and then find it again. So having it in the discard pile is a little bit awkward.
Yeah, and also now we see the escape rope. Our Shortong knows exactly, well, if my opponent gets the Arceus V, then there is Starbirth, the Alakazam can just move out of the active spot. But taking the knockout here would put Alakazam to 220 damage. That is way more than you actually need. And it kind of is in the way of a later Sableye play, where you can just put 20 damage on Radiant Alakazam, and then you have still 100 damage left if you can take completely somewhere else. So using this play just has a complete better damage distribution, and these big Duraludon, Arceus, Umbreon, VMAX decks, the space is a little bit tight. Not all of them play a way to heal their Pokemon. And I think Gabriel also has no way to get rid of this damage. So this is just a big opportunity for Shortong to just take a good knockout very late in the game to seal it up and just leave the Radiant Alakazam there.
Yeah, you don't want a two-hit KO Radiant Alakazam. That is not a good plan, especially when you've got something like Sableye that can, you know, just take those cheeky prizes later on in the game. So hitting that Umbreon. And then, of course, when you hit the Umbreon, you kind of put your opponent on a clock. You say, look, mate, you got one turn. If you do not VMAX this Umbreon right now, I'm going to KO it with Cramorant. And we've seen this time and again. If you can get a two-hit KO on a two-prize Pokemon with a Cramorant before you lose a prize, you know that's the kind of game that Lost Zone decks very rarely lose. If you can start pulling that off, it is going to be huge. Now, we do at least, Gabriel has a double Arceus V-Star here, got the Star Birth off. So, you know, we did see that Luminion come down in the end. So we've got a much better setup here. And it looks like we are going to see Arceus V-Star using that Trinity Nova, taking a KO on the Cramorant, and then accelerating energy. But the problem is that the Pokemon you're accelerating, you know, you put the energy on the Umbreon here. That Umbreon has got a lot lower HP. It is very much in Dragon Knight V range now, even if it V-maxes.
Yeah, also it only has 90 HP left. So it's even possible to just take a knockout on the bench with a Sableye. So it's very difficult for Gabriel to decide where to actually attach the energy cards to. Yeah, very good choice to go for the Arceus V-Star, a Pokemon that is not, well, theoretically is probably able to take a knockout, but that would be asking for so much. Just make the safe play. And the Umbreon, if you have a double turbo energy, you can still attack with it later on in the game if you really want to. But here, just trying to play around potential, yeah, Lost Mind plays as it's now Shortong's turn. We see a Mirage Gate coming down, putting some energy cards in play. There is also a Sableye on the bench, and it seems like Shortong is eyeing up those easy prize cards on the bench, Umbreon V.
I mean, when you've got a chance to take, and obviously you can get the Iridian Alakazam as well, because that's not got much HP left, I don't believe.
Yes.
I believe you can get both of them in one Lost Mind here from Sableye. And, you know, when you can pop Sableye for a single energy and take three prizes while also really hurting your opponent's setup, like, those Pokemon aren't played for nothing. Radiant Alakazam moves damage counters. That's really good. Umbreon, when you evolve into the V-Max, you get a free Gust, and it's a pretty good attacker. That's pretty good. Losing those Pokemon as well as actually giving up those three prizes, I think it's fair to say a less than ideal situation.
Yeah, less than ideal indeed. Chorus's experiment now putting the Lost Zone counter over the edge that is needed to use the Lost Mine attack after the flower selecting, which we will definitely see, I think. Two escape ropes. Seems
ideal.
Like a very difficult choice for Shortong. Like one card he already put down was like, yeah, I'm 100% taking that one. And then there was a consideration about the other four cards. Yeah, I think using escape rope here, completely fine. We already saw a lot of value coming out of the early escape rope. Later on in the game, it sometimes even stands in your way if you just want to take a knockout on the active strong attacker and your only switching option is the one that just allows your opponent to basically run away from you. As we see another Mirage Gate, just attaching some energy cards, preparing a second Sableye, just trying to outplay any potential Judge, any potential Iono plays. The second energy also going to the Comfey. Always
so
funny to see.
Twice.
Yes, exactly. You could attach to the bench one. It doesn't really make a difference, but it kind of shows a little bit of the personality from the players, right?
Yeah.
Do I have like one lovely Comfey that I just want to use multiple times, or do I change it a little bit? As we saw, I think they forgot to use flower selecting.
Only got 9 cards in the Lost Zone.
No.
Sableye's Lost Mind means you have to have 10 cards in the Lost Zone in order to drop those damage counters, and there aren't at the moment. We've got a 9 on the screen, we've got a 9 on the dice on the table. I think that's pretty conclusive. There are only 9 cards in the Lost Zone. There was a flower selecting potentially available, and then try and pivot into the Sableye after that. That would have allowed it. I mean, as far as I am aware, essentially, once you've entered the attack phase, you have to attack. So I believe we would be able to use whatever that first attack is. Is it for 20 damage?
It is. Let's see once the final decision of the judge comes down. Yeah, you could see, we all knew it. Using flower selecting was definitely part of Shortong's turn. He had everything perfectly planned out. And just sometimes in your head, you already have the play completely in your head, and then sometimes you forgot, like, you already did something. This is a very high-pressure situation, and as Ross is correct, this is different, I think, outside of the of our play region in the Asian countries, they have a different rule for this, actually. So it kind of becomes a little bit weird at the World Championship, where some of these like very, very small rules are a little bit different. Here at the World Championship, at least, if you say an attack name and you cannot use it, this still means you're using an attack. You can choose another one or not attack, but you're not allowed to play any cards anymore. Yeah. As we see this great, yeah, very, very small mistake. Completely understandable, everyone can make it, but Gabriel now knows I have to make use of this small slip-up from my opponent. This is the World Championship. If you want to win, you have to play everything perfectly.
And, you know, let's be clear here, you know, we've taken the junior division players, we're putting them on the stream, and that's not something we usually do, of course, only in the finals of big tournaments. You've got the big headphones with your white noise in, you're on the stage, you've got the lights, you've got the cameras. It's a very nerve-wracking situation to be up there on the stage. Now, we do see a Clara coming down from Xiao Tong here. That's going to get that Sableye straight back. And a psychic energy and a water energy, you know, really basically saying, look, I know Sableye is still a very good play. And of course, that Dragonite comes down. Didn't even need Super Rod in the end. Clara did it nicely.
Yeah, the big problem is that Gabriel was able to find that Umbreon VMAX evolving the Umbreon on the bench, which was, yeah, a big liability until now. Now it has a lot more HP than it had before. 310, if I'm not mistaken. So 200 HP left. These are two attacks that you need to use for Sableye, but a Dragonite V could take the one-hit knockout.
Yeah, you're right. It is 310, and yeah, I'm eyeing it down with a Dragonite. So I still love the Sableye play here, but I'm not sure if you necessarily want to go after the Umbreon here. So what we're doing here, we're setting it up. So we've got five on the Aluminium, and then it looks like we got one on the active as well. And we still got some left over. So it looks like we're going to have
should
some.
Should be four, right? Yeah.
Yes, let's go for that. So yeah, there's four on the bench, Arceus, spreading it round and basically going, that Umbreon, I'm not going to get it with Lost Mind. Lost Mind is not going to KO the Umbreon. Yes. I can get that with Dragonite later. For now, let's spread some damage around. And you'll notice, like, everything is now in Dragonite range. So Dragonite, absolutely the star of game one. And Xiao Tong is setting up for maybe that being the case again here. And actually, Arceus does not naturally get a KO on Dragonite. But Dragonite now can KO any of those Pokemon on Gabriel's side of the field.
Yeah, and the 50 damage on the Luminion, very nice. This puts it at 120 HP remaining. Just a single Lost Mind to take the easy knockout on the bench.
Yep.
And then the moment Gabriel decides to put the Umbreon VMAX active, a single knockout draws you three prize cards together with the one prize card taken from Radiant Alakazam. This would seal up the game. Alternatively, there is, I think, a boss is not available, right?
Boss's Orders?
Yes.
Not seeing it in the deck list.
Yeah,
no.
So some people choose a single Boss's Orders for their Lost Zone decks. Especially with a Kyogre, you can deal a lot of like bench damage. You can take potentially Manaphy out with Sableye, so it's not too important to use. But a Boss's Orders would be amazing. Xiao Tong knows, well, I have to win somehow with Lost Mine and also attacking into active Pokemon here.
Yeah, that Umbreon has just become a gigantic liability. I mean, essentially, if we follow it through, so we are seeing Lost Mine coming down here. Are we just going after the Luminion? Is it just a straight KO on the Luminion?
Yes, and also very important for Gabriel, he was able to use a Lost City, which is a very interesting card in this matchup because it puts the opponent's Pokemon into the Lost Zone, which gets them faster to the amount of cards they need in the Lost Zone. But as you saw already, game one and yesterday all the time, Super Rod, Clara, those are very important cards in the deck because you sometimes have to put cards into the Lost Zone that you don't really want to put there, and then you can just outplay your opponent. Well, Lost City, put the last attacker into the Lost Zone. As we see now, Sableye is not even an option for Xiao Tong anymore in the future as this game goes down to the wire. Xiao Tong just needs to take three prize cards. In theory, that is a single knockout, but getting the Umbreon VMAX active is very difficult. We see Dragonite V, only three cards left in the deck. This might be like an amazing setup for a future Kyogre play. As we know, the Kyogre is available, and this might be it. If there is a way to get enough energy cards into the deck to use Mirage Gate and then to attack with Kyogre,
Xiao
you
Tong's
can deal 200 damage on the benched Umbreon.
So
Chaotong, it looks like it is definitely a possibility. Just don't mess up. Count your cards first. Make sure that you play everything in exactly the right order.
So there's the energy recycler. That is making sure your entire deck is just energy cards and nothing else. Then we're going to see, we're probably going to need to see a double energy recycler here. There we go. You need to make sure, there's a Mirage Gate on there. And now you can just attack with, Are we there? There's a second energy recycler we're waiting for. Now we can attack with the Kyogre. Aquastorm is going to do so much damage. It's going to take out those bench Pokemon. And Xiaotongan is your Junior Division World Champion.
Amazing game right here. We saw some, very little hiccup in the game. But Xiaotong, this did not destroy his mental state. He knew I have to pull through as long as I play correctly. From now onward, I can just pick up an easy win. Xiaotong practiced so much with this deck, played it the whole season, got to be a master with it, and now showing everyone here that he is the world champion of the junior division.
Oh, I like the end of that game, David. I love a good Aquastorm. I love seeing a game end on an Aquastorm. This is not the first time I've seen it. It is the first time I've seen it in the junior world championships. And that was wonderful, of course. There may well have been some people at home when we said there's no Boss's Orders in the deck going, hang on a second, Boss's Orders is a great card. That's why. Because actually, as much as it was set up for a big Boss's Orders KO, and it was also set up for a giant Aquastorm with Kyogre. And that was, I think it actually KO'd the Arceus as well.
Yes, Xiaotong with that one lost mine in the middle of the game put both of these Arceus Vs to 250 damage to make this play possible. He actually drew five prize cards. In theory, he could have taken five prize cards with that one attack.
Didn't even need five prize cards.
Exactly. It was completely unnecessary. The game was already over so hard as we see the emotions, realizing that's me. I made it. I am the Pokemon World Champion. This must be such an amazing feeling.
Yeah, it's just, I've never been there myself, but whenever I see the players and, just the emotion coming out there, imagine starting the Pokemon trading card game, getting a year and a half into your journey, and then just being like, oh wait, I'm literally the best in the world at this.